And this is one of the problems a lot of people have been complaining about on EDSA and other roads, all the motorcycle riders taking shelter under the footbridges. Now, one of the complaints from the riders is, if it's zero visibility, what are we meant to do? Well, if it's zero visibility for you, it's also zero visibility for everyone else. So if you stop on a busy highway, you're a major risk to yourself and to everyone else. So what the MMDA have been saying is, if you have to stop, put on your raincoat and then leave immediately. Or better yet, pull into a gas station, onto an easement or another safe place, instead of stopping on the busy highway. Many of the riders have said that they simply don't have a raincoat, and that's why they have to stay here. The thing is, there's only two seasons in the Philippines, right? It's either sunny or it's rainy. So every year you know the rain is going to come, invest in a raincoat. Look at all these motorcycle riders going past, right? They are riding, they're going to work, they're going to wherever they have to be. It's the minority that are stopping on the highway and then causing traffic and accidents potentially for everyone else, right? And I understand it's hard to ride an MC, especially if it's raining, but there's a better place to pull over instead of just doing it in the bridge or the tunnel. And that reminds me of the rider that was interviewed before. He said if he doesn't have a booking, he will stay under the footbridge, but if he has a booking, he will ride. So it means he's able and willing to ride in the rain, but only if he has a booking. The team stopped now because these men were allegedly fighting. The gentleman on the right claims that the guy on the left pickpocketed him, and then he had to fight him to get his cell phone back.
Huwag kang sumigaw. Hindi mo kami madadaan sa sigaw. Ha?
Ha? Masyado ka, magnanakaw ka.
Anong nangyari? Paano mo naramdaman?
Nagulat ako. Dumaan yung ano ko yun, tapos nasa likod ko siya. Tapos bigla-bigla tumiretso dito. So nakita ko. Wala na. Hindi, ito na sir. Nakita ko hawak niya eh.
Hawak niya?
Hindi ako. Kinagulat ko, hawak ko po.
So they're escorting them to station 10, and allegedly things are even worse now because the alleged suspect has a wallet that allegedly has suspected inside. So obviously this is for PNP to deal with. This service road was actually turned into paid parking by the barangay, which is actually being honored by the MMDA. But what they're not honoring is those people that park outside of the allocated spaces. For example, this vehicle here is parked on the corner. That's why the enforcer over there wrote out the ticket, and it is possible that this will be towed away. I remember the last time the team were here, the residents were literally screaming cuss words at them. So it's hard to do your job when there's people like that. The enforcer's been trying to ask this driver for his license, but keeps trying to drive away. He was also parked outside one of the approved spaces. Like I mentioned, the MMDA are honoring those who are parked in the proper spaces allocated by the barangay, but not those who are parked in the wrong place. At the end of the day, this is actually a public road anyway. It's not actually a parking lot. It's just something that the barangay allowed. According to the enforcer, the guy that was actually trying to drive away in this vehicle doesn't have a license. And now he's parked it and he's left. Oh look, now a different guy came out. So who was the guy that was driving it earlier? According to someone nearby, this is owned by, but I have no way to verify that. Residents should really consider themselves fortunate that the barangay have taken so much of the public road and allocated it for parking, right? That's a huge bonus to you because you don't have to have a garage of your own, you just use the public road. But this one over here, you'll see it's parked on the sidewalk, and that's why the towing crew are picking it up now. That will go to Tomana in Marikina City. Aside from the cars, there's a couple motorcycles on the sidewalk also, but those have drivers, so it's just a ticket instead of being impounded. If the barangay are running out of spaces for residents, they might want to consider removing vehicles like this that have flat tires, right? You're occupying limited spaces and the vehicles probably aren't even being used. There is another one here that was parked up against the corner of the curb. Not in an allocated space, so it's going up on the tow truck. And actually, it's the same with this one over here, parked on the corner. You can see they do actually paint the curb to remind people not to park there. Anyway, outside of an allocated space, so it's being towed away. I know I've said it before, but just to remind you that taxis, jeeps, and other franchise transport like this are actually meant to have their own off-street parking, their own garage. But as you see nearly every day, the sidewalks and roads are filled with illegally parked vehicles. And so far, no drivers come out for this taxi, so my guess is it's going to be impounded. And in fact, just a little further along, you can see this one is already being hooked up by the tow truck. And probably that brown one behind also. They're using the sidewalk as a VIP parking space. That's why all the pedestrians in this area are walking in the road. This driver tried to leave before he could be ticketed for obstructing the sidewalk, but no such luck. He's still being ticketed. It looks like the owner already came out for the brown one, so she could actually just take a ticket and then move it. See all the pedestrians here walking in the road? In fact, look, I just saw that lady there in a wheelchair in the bicycle lane. Why does that happen? Because the sidewalks get full of obstructions. The sidewalk is actually relatively flat in this area. You can use it as long as there's no cars parked there. And in fact, there goes that taxi from earlier. They're already pulling it off the sidewalk. CR lang ako. But look at the windscreen. It's got a foil cover. Multiple residents have said that this vehicle has been abandoned here and they're asking the MMDA to remove it. That's a big problem when people just abandon vehicles and they don't move them for a long time. You can see that the front tire is flat. Obviously, it's covered in dust and dirt. If you want to dump a car on your own private property, no problem. No one can stop you. But the moment you leave it on public property, that's the time when you could have a problem. Now, if they had an accident and they had to leave it here in an emergency or something like that, okay, fair enough. But the barangay captain said it's been here for a long time. So, should have been removed already by whoever owns it. And if you look underneath, that's another classic sign that hasn't moved for a long time because the street sweepers can't get there to tidy it up. Whether anyone will ever claim that vehicle, I don't know. For now, you know already, Tomana, Narakina City. These jeeps were parked in the loading bay without any drivers inside. They just came running over now. Obviously, they'll still be ticketed for illegal parking. And that guy is taking his chicken out of the road, out of the sidewalk. A lot of people just treat public spaces and as an extension of their home for their business. The driver of this jeepney keeps trying to drive away. He hasn't given his license yet. The one at the back has. So apparently the guy inside told the enforcer he's not the driver and he doesn't have the license. So why did he jump inside, start the engine and try to drive away? As you saw, the guy walked away and no one came back. So the towing crew is hooking up to it now to clear it from the road.